sorry, out off Port Fairy today. I haven't taken the boat out for about 8 weeks. It's been a wild and windy winter, but finally gotten a little break and with some good weather. So we've come out off Port Fairy, looking for barrels, but spent the last 3 days with no luck. Hasn't been too much around. Plenty of life, plenty of birds, dolphins and seals and stuff, but no tunas. So we've decided we're going to have a gummy session today. So we're just anchored up pretty deep. We're not deeper than 60, but over 40 sort of thing. Doesn't really matter where you're going. Just find a spot and burley up. So I'll show you sort of what rigs, what baits and how we're burleying. And we'll, fingers crossed, we might hook up onto a few gumbos. So with our bait selection, that you don't need to get too picky. Obviously, just something that's pretty bloody, pretty oily will do the trick. Fresh is best. So last night we actually went and threw some soft plastics and caught a whole heap of yakkers. So these is fresh bait, are just dynamite. And then we've got just got some frozen slimy mackerels, got some squid, got some pilchards here. I'm using the pilchards more so for burley, just cubing them up or crushing them up like that. Then we've got the burley pot back here, which has got a logger net, which we just keep swishing around. So as we're keeping a constant burley trail, just pumping out the back. If we do get pest species, it's not a big deal. I mean, the more action that's happening down on the bottom, probably the better. So we're happy just to burley up as hard as we can. We're using big baits, big fillets, or even half fish, because we want to try and get the big fish. So to hook up my yakkers, I cut them off just like that, and then I'll just pin my hook straight through his nose. And then that way it sort of sits nice and straight in the current. It doesn't, it won't be spinning around. It'll just hold nice and straight. So that we can also just knock a fillet off him. And then that can just go out. Again, you just pin the hook through the top so that it's just flapping around in the current. And all of these are going to work. Even the whole squid head, using the tube of the squid, anything will do the trick. It's just a matter of having your bait on the bottom, checking that it's not spinning in the current, and just regular checks to make sure that it hasn't been picked off. So the rigs we're using your paternoster rigs and also just running rigs. So with the paternoster, these obviously go straight down, and they're just you call your bottom bashing rigs. So to pin this on, as I said before, just go straight through the nose like that, through the tough bits, out the bottom, and that's it, simple as that. So, and then I just drop him straight to the bottom, and just once it hits the bottom, I'm just sort of winding my line so that it's tight, but so that it's sitting on the bottom. I don't want it lifted up off. So as soon as it hits the bottom, we are quite deep, so it takes a fair while to get down. Eventually it does stop, there we go. So I'm just winding the line tight, making sure that it's on the bottom. Straighten the rod holder, and that's it. Now, I like to leave the rods in the rod holder. If I'm getting nibbles, I don't touch the rod. I just leave it. I'll let it sit there, wait for that rod to bend over and line starts peeling off. That's when you can get the rod out of the holder. The circle hooks and the rod holder and the tight drag are gonna do all the work for you. You don't need to strike it at all. Fucking oath.
Everybody's got a mic now. It's like a hobby, or more like a job. That's moving like a son of rock.
So the other rig we're using, we got the easy slider rig. So I've just got easy slider on the main line to the swivel. Now I'm actually using a 60 pound metal trace or metal leader. It's got a nylon coating on it. So the sharks, if they brush up against it, they don't sense the metal. So this stuff works well. I mean, you will get more bites and, you know, more hookups with your mono, but there is a lot of schoolies and seven gillers and who knows what else is out here. So just got one rod with a metal trace. So just using a sort of 8-ounce sinker. Just, you don't want to overdo your sinker, just enough to sort of hold bottom and the rods aren't moving around too much. So to bait this up, it's got a slimy mackerel head. So I'm just gonna put that on like that and gonna get a little bit fancy. I'm gonna whack a yakka fillet on it too. So that's it, just like that. It's just one pin through the whole lot. Now, because all the paternosters are straight down, what I wanna do is I'm gonna cast this out the back so it's sitting right out the back, out of the road. And then just keep letting the line come off so that the bait falls down there. If you click it over too early, it's just gonna swing straight back to you. So just keep letting the line out down there. Then eventually it does stop. There we go. So it's making sure the drag's not too tight, but tight enough to hold the hook. Make sure that sinker hasn't sunk into any mud. And boom, that's it. In the rod holder, and that's ready for action. Double hook up.
Sure?
Yeah. Got it.
You're kidding.
And tighten the drag there. Yes! Double hook up. This is what we play this game for, baby. Yes! Oh yeah! Oh, that is such a shark.
Yeah, hold that one.
Ready?
Do you care if I fucking...
No, I'll pop them off. Wait, can you just keep filming with that?
Imagine a gummy that big. Oh, that's what Billy does to you, mate.
Holy shit. So that's on mono.
Nice little bend in the trace.
Can you move that other one? I'll put it on this side of the boat. So I can move it over. Come on, Captain.
Whole thing in it. Oh, I'm doing
that. Look at that bend in the rod, mate.
I reckon I can't snap this rod.
Yeah, I reckon that's fucking close to snapping. Look at that bend, bro.
Mate, I catch tuna on this fucker.
Sick, bro. Yeah, he's a filled.
Yeah.
Oh, he's all wrapped up. Fuck yeah.
Oh,
you're
gonna lose
it by the
way, bro. Fucking nice.
Third for the day, boys.
It's all right, bro.
So we've ended up getting three gummies. The biggest is probably this one, about 5 or 6 kilos or so. So it's been a good day. We got a big 7-gilla, few eagle rays, draft board sharks, Port Jackson sharks, all the normal pest species that you get with the gummies. But they're pretty happy to pull in three. So a lot of flake there. So we're bloody laughing here.